I'm Kelly Warner. Our local communities have experienced a lot of respiratory illnesses over the last 5 months. And for some children, it's led to an unexpected condition involving coughing and wheezing called viral-induced asthma. It's important for parents to be aware of how it occurs and to recognize the symptoms so children can be treated appropriately. After a long season of community sickness, providers at Eugene Pediatric Associates are seeing a lot of kids experiencing viral-induced asthma.
They cough and cough for weeks after the illness is over. They cough at night. They cough when they're running or exercising. They cough when they're screaming or crying. Anytime that their body would want a big, easy breath, that's when viral-induced asthma hits.
Pediatrician Dr. Pilar Bradshaw says viral-induced asthma is not caused by allergies, which is typically seen in older kids and adults with asthma. She says it's repeated exposure to respiratory viruses, including colds, flu, and RSV, that takes a toll on young lungs.
Their lungs are literally tiny. They're just still developing. And those little lungs get irritated and triggery the next time a virus comes around.
Viral-induced asthma does not improve with cough syrups or other over-the-counter remedies. Instead, Dr. Bradshaw says,
if you could give a child who has viral-induced asthma a rescue inhaler, it will immediately start to cut their cough. Allow them to sleep, allow them to exercise and run around outside in the cold air without having a cough. But also, importantly, the next time their child gets a runny nose, before it gets down to their chest, they can grab for their medication and prevent it from sinking in and lasting as a weeks-long cough.
Viral-induced asthma is typically not a permanent condition, but needs treatment. If you're concerned that your younger children may have viral-induced asthma, be sure to talk with your pediatrician. Learn more at eugenepeds.com/healthykids. I'm Kelly Warner.